So good morning to one and all. So today our topic is testing and inspection of welding joints. So let us go. Okay. Let us move to our topic. So coming to the introduction. So this is the NDT antonym. దీన్ని మనం ఏమంటామంటే NDT non destructive testing. టెస్టింగ్ అండ్ ఇన్స్పెక్షన్ అని అన్నారు కదా, దెన్ వాట్ యు ఆర్ సేయింగ్ ఎన్డిటీ, వై యు ఆర్ సేయింగ్ ఎన్డిటీ మీన్స్ ఇన్ అవర్ ఇన్స్పెక్షన్ లెవెల్ వి ఆర్ హ్యావింగ్ టోటల్ టూ టైప్స్ ఆఫ్ టెస్టింగ్ అండ్ ఇన్స్పెక్షన్స్. వన్ ఈజ్ డిస్ట్రక్టివ్ టెస్టింగ్, ద సెకండ్ వన్ ఈజ్ నాన్ డిస్ట్రక్టివ్ టెస్టింగ్, రైట్? సో టెస్టింగ్ అండ్ ఇన్స్పెక్షన్ ఆఫ్ వెల్డింగ్ వెల్డెడ్ జాయింట్స్ ఈజ్ డన్ ఆన్ ద సేమ్ లైన్స్ యాజ్ ఫర్ కాస్టింగ్స్, రైట్? So the tests fall under two categories. One is destructive testing and the second one is the non-destructive testing. The tests are done on a sample to improve the design of the weld and weld technique, etc., and to know the mechanical properties of the weldment these mechanicals tests included tensile test, bend test, impact strength test, hardness test, and relative elongation test, and these are all comes under to non destructive testing. So right, whereas coming to the non destructive test, we are having so many things, but according to our syllabus we are having a little bit of tests only. So in that, visual inspection is the comes to the non destructive test. So coming to the introduction to non destructive testing, so this is the definition. It is the main non-destructive testing definition. Here, what is going on here? The use of non-invasive techniques to determine the integrity of a material component or structure, or quantitatively measure some characteristic of an object. So inspect anna, measure anna, so the values. మెజర్ చేస్తాం, ఇన్స్పెక్ట్ ఆర్ మెజర్ వితౌట్ డూయింగ్ హామ్. ఎటువంటి హామ్ కండిషన్స్ ఏమి కలగకుండా, జస్ట్ విత్ ద విజువల్ రేస్ ఓన్లీ వీ విల్ గెట్ ద టోటల్ క్వాంటిటేటివ్లీ మెజర్మెంట్స్. సో దిస్ ఈస్ అబౌట్ ద డెఫినేషన్ ఆఫ్ ఎన్డిటీ. సో దిస్ ఈస్ ద డిఫరెంట్ టైప్స్ ఆఫ్ మెథడ్స్ ఆఫ్ ఎన్డిటీ. సో నాన్ డిస్ట్రక్టివ్ టెస్టింగ్, ఎన్డిటీ మీన్స్ నాన్ డిస్ట్రక్టివ్ టెస్టింగ్. వన్ ఈజ్ ట్యాప్ టెస్టింగ్, second one is microwave, and third one is thermography. So magnetic particle, acoustic microscopy. Okay, I will unlock the room, just wait. Is it clear? So right, so these are all the on screen we have been shared so many types of methods of NDT. Laser interferometry, eddy current application, replication, liquid penetrant, flux leakage, ultrasonic. So these are all comes under to the different methods of NDT. So right, so what are the some of the uses of NDT? Enduku ee NDT ante a joint manam edaithe welding ఇన్ఫర్మేషన్ ఏంటది అంటే, వాట్ ఈస్ ద మెజర్మెంట్ కానీ, వాట్ ఈస్ ద డిఫెక్ట్స్ అని కానీ, ఇవన్నీ కూడా మెజర్ చేయాలంటే వీఆర్ హ్యావింగ్ సమ్ టెస్టింగ్ అనేది చేయాలి. ప్రతి ఫైనల్ ప్రోడక్ట్కి కూడాను వీ మస్ట్ డూ సర్టైన్ టెస్టింగ్స్. సో అందులో డిస్ట్రక్టివ్ టెస్టింగ్ ఉంటుంది, అంటే కంప్లీట్ ఇట్ మే బి హ్యావింగ్ సర్టైన్ టెన్సైల్ టెస్ట్ అంటే ఏంటి, పైనుంచి లోడ్ అప్లై చేస్తే ఏమవుతుంది, జాయింట్ మే బి బ్రేక్అప్. సో దాన్ని డిస్ట్రక్టివ్ అంటాము, ఏదైనా పగిలిపోయేలాగా విరిగిపోయేలాగా చేస్తే దాన్ని డిస్ట్రక్టివ్ టెస్టింగ్ అంటాం. కమింగ్ టు ద నాన్ డిస్ట్రక్టివ్ టెస్టింగ్, ఇట్ ఈస్ నో డిస్టర్బెన్స్ ఎట్ ఆల్. సో కమింగ్ టు దట్, వీఆర్ హ్యావింగ్ సో మెనీ టెస్ట్. వన్ ఈజ్ విజువల్ ఇన్స్పెక్షన్, అండ్ ద సెకండ్ వన్ ఈజ్ హైడ్రాలిక్ టెస్ట్, అండ్ ద థర్డ్ వన్ ఈజ్ ఎయిర్ టెస్ట్, అండ్ రేడియోగ్రఫిక్ ఇన్స్పెక్షన్, ఫ్లోరసెంట్ పెనిట్రెంట్ ఇన్స్పెక్షన్, మ్యాగ్నెటిక్ ఇన్స్పెక్షన్, అమోనియా పెనిట్రెంట్ టెస్ట్. So right, so what are the uses? One is flaw detection and evaluation. Second one is leak detection. third one is location determination, fourth one is dimensional measurements, fifth one is structure and microstructure characterization, and fifth one is estimation of mechanical and physical properties, and next one is stress and dynamic response measurements, and last one is material sorting and chemical composition determination. So these are all the uses of NDT methods, right? So these are all, what are the methods? These are all the different methods in our NDT. So using these methods, what are the uses? These are all the different uses for the NDT methods. So right, so coming to the, what are the methods used? We are having so many lot of methods. So when the methods has been used, ekkada use chestam? So dani gusthe we are having so many things to be followed. So one is to assist in product development. Second one is to screen or sort incoming materials. And third one is to monitor, improve or control manufacturing processes. And next one is to verify proper processing such as heat treating, to verify proper assembly, and to inspect for in-service damage. So these are all the different conditions we have to apply where the NDT has been used, right? So coming to the six most NDT used. So this is one of the important thing. So what are the different NDT techniques? మేడం మరి డిస్ట్రక్టివ్ టెస్టింగ్ అన్నారు. డిస్ట్రక్టివ్ టెస్టింగ్ ఈజ్ ఆల్రెడీ మనం ఏ ల్యాబ్లో ఎంఓఎస్ ల్యాబ్లో మనం చూడొచ్చు. నన్ను టెన్సైల్ స్ట్రెంగ్త్ కానీ టెస్టులు చేస్తారు మీరు, ఇవన్నీ ఇంపాక్ట్ టెస్ట్ ఇవన్నీ కూడా. వేర్ యాజ్ నాన్ డిస్ట్రక్టివ్ టెస్టింగ్ మీరు ఇప్పటివరకు ఎక్కడ చూసి ఉండరు. సో దట్స్ వై ఐ హ్యావ్ బీన్ వన్ మోర్ టైమ్ ఐ హ్యావ్ బీన్ షేర్డ్ ద క్లాసిఫికేషన్. దీస్ ఆర్ ఆల్ ద మెయిన్ ఇంపార్టెంట్ థింగ్స్ విచ్ వీ హ్యావ్ బీన్ ఇన్ అవర్ సిలబస్ కంటెంట్. సో రైట్. So coming to the visual inspection, second one is liquid penetrant. These are all the most important common methods, NDT techniques we have been used in our industries or fuel combustion process, wherever these are all the NDT techniques we have been used. As a mechanical student, you must know this one. So first one is visual inspection, and second one is liquid penetrant, and third one is magnetic ultrasonic. Just wait. All of you join within the time. Otherwise, you will miss the total topics. Right. So coming to here, second one is liquid penetrant, and third one is a magnetic testing. Fourth one is ultrasonic, and fifth one is eddy current, and sixth one is X-ray techniques. So these are all the main common, six most common important NDT techniques. Wherever after completion of your BTech, some people are taking some training on this NDT techniques also. If you consult your seniors or some people, they are taking some training on this NDT techniques, and they are getting jobs on this also, right? So this is the most important topic. All of you just observe and note down the key points also, right? So this is an add-on topic for our subject. So coming to this visual inspection, here you can observe. So this guy is trying to take some values from the other wherever the component. So this is the component, and this is the visual inspection. So right, the most basic and common inspection method. This is the most common inspection method. So here also this guy is taking a small instrument here, visual inspection, and this is the surface. So a surface with the machine edaithe undo dan apply chesi he is getting the values. So here tools include fiber scopes, bore scopes, magnifying glasses, and mirrors. So these are all the tools included. These are the tools included in our visual inspection. And this is portable video inspection. This is the portable video inspection, right? And of large tanks and vessels. So vessels, whether it is having any leakage or whatever else, according to our requirement, this type of inspection has been used. Inspection of large tanks, vessels, railroad tank cars, sewer lines, etc. So coming to here, robotic crawlers, permit observations in hazardous or tight areas such as air ducts, reactors, pipelines, etc. Right? So coming to this, this is the liquid penetrant inspection. So visual inspection means checking of its dimensions can be revealed by using these inspections. Checking the dimensions of a weld, whatever else the weld has been completed, the visual inspection of the weld and checking its dimensions can reveal. And one more thing here, you can observe by this visual inspection, shape of profile, uniformity of surface, undercuts, surface cavities and slag inclusions, cracks, porosity, unfilled craters. What are the defects? We can also find out the defects by using this visual inspection. So right, so coming to the liquid penetrant test. So here, what is going on here? A liquid with high surface wetting characteristics is applied to the surface of the part and allowed time to seep into the surface, breaking defects. So the excess liquid is removed from the surface of the part. Right, the excess liquid may be removed from the surface of the part and a developer is applied to pull the trapped penetrant over the defect and spread it on the surface where it can be seen. On the surface where it can be seen. And the next one is visual inspection is the final step in the process. So the penetrant used is often loaded with a fluorescent dye and the inspection is done under UV light to increase test sensitivity. So this is about the liquid penetrant test. Okay. Right. Right. So this is the liquid penetrant test. So coming to this. So this is the magnetic particle inspection. The part is magnetized and finally, so finely milled iron particles coated with a dye pigment are then applied to the specimen. Ikkada em avutundante part may be magnetizing. Magnetize chestaniki cheyadaniki em chestam manam finely milled iron particles with maybe coated with a dye, coating untundamma with a dye pigment are then applied to the specimen. Specimen edaithe manaku deni meedaithe manaki test cheyalanukuntunnamo daniki ee finely coated iron particles maybe adhered. Therefore, these particles are attracted to the magnetic flux, leakage fields, and will cluster to form an indication directly. అక్కడ ఏమవుతుంది? ఎక్కడైతే లీకేజ్ ఉంటుందో దాని దగ్గరికి వెళ్ళిపోతే నాన్న ఈ మ్యాగ్నెటిక్ ఫ్లక్స్ వలన ఈ పిగ్మెంట్ ఏదైతే మనం డై యూజ్ చేసి వేర్ ద కోటెడ్ మే బి అప్లైడ్ ఆన్ దట్ పర్టికులర్ ఐరన్ పార్టికల్స్ దేర్ ఫార్ వాట్ ఈస్ హ్యాపెనింగ్ హియర్ దీస్ పార్టికల్స్ ఆర్ అట్రాక్టెడ్ టు ద మ్యాగ్నెటిక్ ఫ్లక్స్ లీకేజ్ ఫీల్డ్స్ అండ్ విల్ క్లస్టర్ టు ఫార్మ్ యాన్ ఇండికేషన్ డైరెక్ట్లీ over the discontinuity. This indication can be visually detected under proper lighting conditions, right? So this is about the magnetic field inspection. So this is the magnetic particle crack indications. You can observe here the greenish color is the magnetic particle crack indication. That is the indication. Here also you can observe the indication. That means the cracks may be identified very easily by using this process, right? So this is the crane hook. Here you can observe, just wait. Okay, so here you can observe this is the crane hook and this is the gear blank. So this is the crane hook indication. This is the cracks may be obtained. Why? Because due to improper conditions applied. So therefore, the cracks may be obtained, but the cracks are not identified with our eyes. Therefore, by using these tests, we can easily identify the cracks behind the at the inner surface also we can easily identify it by using this magnetic particle testing, right? So coming to the radiographic testing. So this is the radiography means ద రేడియోగ్రఫీ ఇన్స్పెక్షన్ ఆఫ్ ద వెల్డ్ దట్ మీన్స్ ఎలా చెప్పాలంటే మీకు ఎక్స్రే అండ్ గామారే టెస్టింగ్ విల్ రివీల్ సచ్ డిఫెక్ట్స్ యాజ్ ఏమేమి చేస్తుందంటే పారోసిటీ బ్లో హోల్స్ క్రాక్స్ ప్యూర్ ఫ్యూజన్ స్లాగ్ ఇన్క్లూజన్ దీస్ ఆల్ థింగ్స్ మేబీ ఈజీలీ ఐడెంటిఫైడ్ బై యూజింగ్ రేడియోగ్రఫిక్ టెస్టింగ్ రైట్ సో ద రేడియోగ్రఫీ యూజ్డ్ ఇన్ రేడియోగ్రఫీ టెస్టింగ్ ఈజ్ ఏ higher energy shorter wavelength that means higher energy means nothing but shorter wavelength version of the electromagnetic waves that we see as visible light we see as the visible light you can observe the diagram all of you just see the diagram so the radiation can come from an x-ray generator or a radioactive source or a radioactive source so you can observe it's a waveform right so coming to the film radiography this is also the radiography test but some more classifications on this so the radiography means the part is placed between the radiation source and a piece of film and a piece of film here also you can observe so this is the x-ray film idi already manam chinna appudu chestuntam somebody 47 don't annotate on my screen so right so this is the x-ray film so this is the developed film so this is the rays which we have been passed on our surface right who is number 47 why you are annotating on my screen If you stop annotating, I will give you the class, a class attendance. Otherwise, I will not give you the attendance. Okay, okay. Carry on. Right. The part is placed between the radiation source and a piece of film. The part will stop some of the radiation. Thicker and more dense area will stop more of the. Radiation the film darkness will vary with the amount of radiation reaching the film through the test object so here you can observe one is less exposure and the second one is more exposure so according to the color coding they can identify right so this is the radiographic images all of it just identified it is not available at our readily in our college it may be available only in this slide share only it is not possible at anywhere it is only possible where the images may be obtained only not available at any place ekkada padithe akkada dorakadu ilaaga images kavali ante we have to search so many things so all of you just look have a look on the radiographic images what it is doing on here right so this is the eddy current testing so coming to the eddy current testing so this is the coil and a coil's magnetic field which is in the blue color so eddy current magnetic field may be generated here and eddy currents is passing on the surface of the conductive material so this is the conductive material and this is the conductive material and this is the eddy currents and this is the eddy current magnetic field and this is the coil using this coil the magnetic field may be generated and this magnetic rays may be passed using eddy currents and therefore the conductive material will conduct the eddy currents and therefore the surface may be detects the defects right so this is the eddy current testing so eddy current testing is particularly well suited for detecting surface cracks but can also be used to make electrical conductivity and coating thickness measurements here a small surface probe is scanned over the part surface in an attempt to detect a crack right so this is the eddy current testing diagram so this is the testing which has been conducted in our laboratory. This guy is taking the eddy current testing on the surface. Heat is the product, and this is the eddy current testing, right? We can easily identify it on the screen. Here there is a screen which is identified with greenish in color, right? So coming to this ultrasonic testing inspection, so high frequency sound waves, high frequency sound waves are introduced into a material and they are reflected back from surfaces or floors. So reflected sound energy is displayed versus time, and inspector can visualize a cross section of the specimen showing the depth of features that reflect the sound. The sound is also available. So that is the pulse echo inspection. Generally, it will called as a pulse echo inspection. So this is the ultrasonic images. High resolution images can be produced by plotting signal strength or time of flight using a computer controlled scanning system, CAPP, computer controlled scanning system. So here you can observe grayscale image produced using the sound reflected from the front surface of the coin, and grayscale image produced using the sound reflected from the back surface of the coin, right? Inspection from head side. Fine student, this is the ultrasonic image, right? So common applications of NDT: inspection of raw material, raw products, inspection following secondary processing, and in services damage inspection. So these are the common applications, right? So inspection of raw products, one is forgings, castings, extrusions, etc. These are all the different types of applications we have been observed in our industries. So right, inspection following the secondary processing, those are all, one is machining, welding, grinding, heat treating, plating, etc. These are all the inspection following the secondary processing. Primary one is forging, casting, extrusions, and the second one is these things: machining, welding, grinding, heat treating, plating, etc. Right? From next time onwards, you must attend within the time. Okay, right. So inspection for in-service damage. So here one is cracking, second one is corrosion, and the third one is erosion. Arigipodani erosion anta. Erosion or wear. And next one is heat damage. So these are all the in-service damage. Ilantappudu manam testings chestanam, right? In-service damage. So power plant inspection. Here periodically power plants are shut down for inspection. Inspectors feed eddy current probes into heat exchanger tubes to check for corrosion damage. Wire rope inspection. So this is the electromagnetic devices and visual inspections are used to find broken wires and other damage to the wire rope that is used in chair lifts, cranes, and other lifting devices. This is the wire rope inspection. This type of this type of wire rope may be conducted the testing regularly. Otherwise, there may be certain. So this is the one crack we have been attained. So this is the testing. These guys are testing. So this is the rope which has been string upon a circular diameter. So coming to the storage tank. Coming to the storage tank inspection, robotic crawlers use ultrasound to inspect the walls of ultrasound to inspect the walls of large above ground tanks for signs of thinning due to corrosion. And second one is cameras and long articulating arms are used to inspect underground storage tanks for damage, right? So this is the storage tank inspection. So this is the aircraft inspection. Non-destructive testing is used extensively during the manufacturing of aircraft. And the second one is NDT is also used to find cracks and corrosion damage during the operation of the aircraft. A fatigue crack that started at the site of a lightning strike is shown below. So you can observe here. So right. So this is the crack, fatigue crack, right? Next, jet engine inspection. So coming to here, aircraft engines are overhauled after being in service for a period of time. They are completely disassembled, cleaned, inspected, and then reassembled. Fluorescent penetrant inspection is used to check many of the parts for cracking, right? Fluorescent inspection. So this is the crash of United Flight 232. So this is happened in 1989, July 19. So a defect that went under undetected in an engine disk was responsible for the crash of United Flight 232. So ivanni kuda eppudukappudu inspection chestuntaru nanu. So right, inspection chestunte ilanti problems risk anevi emi undavu. So engine disk lo manaki chinna undetected problem valana total the flight may be crashed. So this is the crash this is the diagram you can observe here, right? Total the front propeller shaft may be crashed. So this is a pressure vessel inspection. So the failure of a pressure vessel can result in the failure of a pressure vessel result in the rapid release of a large amount of energy to protect against this dangerous event. The tanks are inspected using radiography and ultrasonic testing. Here this guy is identified some crack here. So these are all the pressure testing. This is also taking the pressure testing is in our medical field also, right? Rail inspection. Special cars are used to inspect thousands of miles of rail to find cracks that could lead to a derailment. So right. So this is the rail inspection. Anywhere this NDT is applicable for so many places. So this is the bridge inspection. The US has 578,000 highway bridges. So there. ప్రతి బ్రిడ్జ్కి కూడాను కరోజన్ టెస్ట్ క్రాకింగ్ టెస్ట్ ఇవన్నీ చెయ్యాలి ప్రతి బ్రిడ్జ్కి కూడా. సో కరోజన్ క్రాకింగ్ అండ్ అదర్ డ్యామేజ్ కెన్ ఆల్సో ఎఫెక్ట్ ఎ బ్రిడ్జెస్ పెర్ఫార్మెన్స్. ద కొలాప్స్ ఆఫ్ ద సిల్వర్ బ్రిడ్జ్ ఇన్ 1967 రిజల్టెడ్ ఇన్ లాస్ ఆఫ్ 47 లైవ్స్. సో బ్రిడ్జెస్ గెట్ ఎ విజువల్ ఇన్స్పెక్షన్ అబౌట్ ఎవ్రీ 2 ఇయర్స్. సమ్ బ్రిడ్జెస్ ఆర్ లిఫ్టెడ్ విత్ అకౌస్టిక్ ఎమిషన్ సెన్సార్స్ దట్ listen for sounds of cracks growing. So sound bridge inspection. So coming to this pipeline inspection. So this is NDT is used to inspect pipelines to prevent leaks that could damage the environment. Visual inspection, radiography, and electromagnetic testing are some of the NDT methods used. And this is the first one is the remote visual inspection used a robotic crawler, right? So this is the robotic crawler. Total inspection is also taking the technology, not with our manual inspections. So right. So this is the magnetic flux detection inspection. This device known as a pig is placed in the pipeline and collects data on the condition of the pipe as it is pushed along by whatever is being transported. So radiography of weld joints. So this is the radiography. So coming to this special measurements, so being Boeing employees in some other country, I can't study this one clearly, were given by the privilege of evaluating the Liberty Bell for damage using NDT techniques. So this is the Liberty Bell. Ne, daniki NDT techniques chestu untaru chudandana. Eddy current methods were used to measure the electrical conductivity of the bell's bronze casing at various points to evaluate its uniformity. So right, so here these people are identified a crack here. So these are all the NDT tests. So right, so we are concluding with this, but we have to know some more things here. We are having welding defects. What are the welding defects? I want to say this one is when a weld is completed, the parent metal is hottest at the point of fusion. So the temperature of the base metal progressively decreases further away from the center of the fusion zone. Due to this temperature gradient, a fusion weld and the metal adjacent to it contain various zones having distinctly different grain structures and hence different properties, right? And one thing is various zones. We are having various zones of typical weld. So in the zones, one is the fusion zone, second one is heat affected zone, and third one is weld metal zone, and fourth one is a weld zone, and fifth one is cracks. So these are all comes under to defects. So right, so what are the zones? Various zones means fusion zone, heat affected zone, weld metal zone, weld zone. What is fusion zone? It is the portion of the weld in which the base metal has been fused. Heat affected zone, this is the zone wherein the base metal is metallurgically affected by the heat of welding but is not melted. Weld metal zone, this is the portion of the weld which consists of weld metal. This zone includes any base metal which is melted and resolidified, as well as any filler material which did likewise, right? Whereas weld zone is nothing but weld metal zone plus heat affected zone. Togetherly we are calling it as weld zone, right? So coming to the defects, one is cracks. In that cracks, it may be subdivided into micro cracks and macro cracks and fissures. These are all comes under to defects. Second one is undercuts, porosity, inclusions, lack of fusion, burning, and internal residual stresses and distortion. So we will deal the defects of welding in our next class. So coming to this, I will share one more slides. Wait a minute. So testing of weld joints, we will share one more time. So this is the thing happening here. So welded joints may be carried out of the following reasons. So what are the reasons here? Welding procedure approval, welder approval, production quality. So these are the main things any industry may be maintained. These are the common things for every testing. So welding consumables manufacturer will carry out all weld metal tests for each consumable type. And parent material is normally subjected to extensive testing prior to its acceptance. So this is the mechanical testing. So tensile, these are all the destructive testings. So this is the tensile test. In the academic anni kuda non-destructive testing cheppukunta vachanamma. Coming to this is the tensile test. So this is the graphical representation. This is the graphical representation. Stress strain diagram antam. Prati material ki kuda tensile test chesinappudu we will get the stress strain diagram. So this is the tensile test. So what is happening here? In the tensile test is applied to the opposite direction to pull the ends of the part. So here you can observe. This is the specimen. So this is the specimen. It is pulling both sides. Etla direction lo both sides. It wipe ki both sides. Adi pull chestunnam. Therefore, the piece may be here. It is the welding position. So that is the destructive. Completely viripothadu. The tensile test is used to assess the following. So one is aim find out chestam ante yield point, ultimate strength, ductility of the specimen expressed as percentage of elongation. So these are all the tensile test specimen axis. So ivanni kuda identify chestunnam tensile stress valla ante a load daggara adi break ayipothundi a peak ante a load daggara adi enta varaku damage avakanda alaga daniki ultimate strength anedi undi. So these are all the mechanical properties identified by using these destructive testings. So coming to this tensile test, The reduction of the cross-sectional area indicates the ductile fracture, and steel specimen which do not exhibit any necking usually resected, and UTS is equal to maximum load applied by least cross-sectional area, and percentage of elongation. This is the strain. Already you have been discussed in our MOS class. So strain is equal to increase in length by original length into 100. Therefore, we will get the percentage of the elongation. So even if you have definitions, stress definition, strain definition, modulus, self-elasticity, Young's modulus, even if you have a good fit, you will have a good answer. Final interview, quiz, So, right. So coming to this, the bend is the bend test is carried out to determine the soundness of the weld zone. The commonly applied bend test is the transverse bend test. There are three ways to perform this type of bend test. One is root bend, face bend, third one is side bend. So aim out on the specimen width of the bend test is usually 1.5 times of the thickness, and the weld reinforcement is usually dressed flushed on both sides. The specimens are usually bent 90, 120, 135, 180. So these are all the degrees happening. So this is about the bend test. So this is the bend test. You can observe here. All of you just